guys, Jessica here, the Furry Family Coach. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. If you're having problems with your dog's paw pads being cracked or dry, even hard, or maybe even on their nose, that sometimes happens too, you have definitely clicked on the right video. My dog, Kim, we have gone through like ups and downs with her paw pads, and here's the reason behind it. So I want to get right into what's going on generally. Now, you should definitely consult your veterinarian, but here's what I have found. Dry paw pads, or even if maybe like the top of their nose is getting dry, cracked, brittle, this can be very uncomfortable for your dog, especially if the skin starts to crack. And if your dog has, you know, cracks in their paw pads, that can be very dangerous, very uncomfortable, very painful for your dog. And they might even have to go on like crate rest, because you don't want them walking on asphalt or even getting, you know, dirt, grime, grossness into the cracks of their paw pads if that happens, because it can, you know, you don't want it to get infected. So, of course, you know, as part of our routine, I know with my dog, she sits on the couch with me at night and I'm petting her. But while I'm petting her, I'm also, you know, checking out for any bumps, lumps, cuts, anything that may be sore. I might be, you know, kind of massaging at her paws, at her joints. And if anything is sore, you know, she'll react and I'll be able to know what's going on. I'm also we're just checking things out. We're looking in their ears and making sure, you know, nothing is inflamed or red. So this is just something, a normal everyday thing that happens when you have a dog and her paw pads do get dry and brittle. Fortunately, we have maintained them well enough that they have never cracked. But here's what I found is actually happening. So we need to be paying attention to the nutrition that our dogs are getting. My dog Kim eats a raw food diet, and for the majority of her diet, she eats a frozen patty, which I do thaw, and I oftentimes will let it warm up at least to room temperature because, and I've talked about this in other videos, we know, Dr. Judy Morgan says this a lot, when we eat cold foods, especially with your dog, if they're eating a frozen or really cold food, it slows down the movement of their intestines, which can, which just increases time for digestion and things start stagnating. So I often will let her, unless it's a really hot day, then I'll let her enjoy a cold treat. But I will often let her food warm up to, you know, close to room temperature before I feed it. But the fact that I'm feeding her a frozen patty, the longer a food stays frozen, vitamin E specifically, this is what we're talking about, very specifically, vitamin E over extended periods of time starts to degrade. So when you make a food and it is completely balanced and it has the perfect amount of vitamin E that your dog or cat needs in their diet, if frozen for an extended period of time, the vitamin E starts to degrade and isn't the same level as if you had fed that food fresh. So feeding Kim a raw food diet, that's literally the only drawback that I have found, is that I do have to supplement with vitamin E on occasion. And one of the best ways to do that is with healthy fish oils. So I will feed her sardines, but she gets tired of them. Like, I generally will only give her sardines once a week. But even that, she sometimes gets tired of them. And I understand that. I mean, none of us want to eat the same things over and over and over again. So what can we do about those dry, brittle paw pads? Well, I've tried different things over the years, and I've recently tried this Natural Dog Company Paw Soother. And I will put a link in the description below. You can just grab it on Amazon. And this has really worked wonders. We use it regularly. And generally what I'll do is just after last call, last potty break of the night, she goes out and does her business and she comes inside and gets in bed. That's when I will put this on her paws. And it's in this, like, it looks like a stick of deodorant. So you literally just take the lid off and rub this on her paws, and I'll show you how I do it. And that's all you do. And it has really helped to make her paws not quite so dry and brittle. So if you are having this issue, first of all, like I said, we want to supplement that vitamin E in the diet, because having dry and brittle skin is a sign that you're not getting that, or your dog is not getting enough vitamin E. And this is the same thing with us. If our nails are brittle, or if our skin gets really dry, we can even rub vitamin E right directly on it, or we start taking a vitamin E supplement, because vitamin E is really good for the skin and coat. And with Kim, like I said, eating a frozen diet, the longer that food is frozen, the more vitamin E we have to supplement. So it's kind of like up and down as to how much we need to supplement. And sometimes she doesn't want to eat the sardines, and I get that. So we really like this paw soother. So I wanted to share this with you guys. If you have used paw soother, let me know in the comments below. Or if you've tried other things and you're just like, what can I do? Go ahead and put that in the comments below as well. I would really love to know, once you get the paw soother and start using it with your dog, you can also, it helps to soothe, moisturize, and protect. So, it's all organic. It has, here, I'm gonna read these to you. So, the directions say, apply to paw pads frequently and to distract your dog while the balm soaks in. So you don't wanna let your dog lick it off. Paw soother is a nourishing butter and herbal blend, which you can smell. And you can smell the herbs when you open it up. It's a nourishing butter and herbal blend that soothes, moisturizes, and heals dry, rough, and irritated pads fast. The ingredients, it's all made in the USA. You can also find it at naturaldog.com. It's all made in the USA, and the ingredients are organic kupaku, I'm not sure if I'm saying that right, kupaku butter, organic coconut oil, organic hemp seed oil, organic jojoba oil, candelilla wax, chamomile, organic cajeput, calendula, rosemary, that's what you can really smell is the rosemary, and natural vitamin E. So again, like I said, if we get dry skin, we can even oftentimes, like if you have a scar, right? If you get cut or you have surgery and you don't want to have a scar, that's what you do. You take vitamin E oil and you rub it in every day, twice a day sometimes, and you rub it in, and that's what helps prevent scarring. So this, just the fact that it has vitamin E in it, I'm telling you guys, if you're having this issue, the first thing you want to do is supplement their food with vitamin E, but also try this paw soother. I really like it, and this is not sponsored at all. I just wanted to kind of share with you what I've been going through and what I have found that has worked. And this may not be the last thing I ever try, but for right now, this is what we're going to stick with, because it really does work, and I really like it. Again, guys, if you have any questions, any comments, please do post them in the comment section below. And I would love to know if you've tried this, if you haven't tried this, if you're gonna try this, let me know what's going on with your dog and why you clicked on this video. That's what the comments are for. Also, check the description below for a link to the group. There are thousands of other pet parents there waiting for you to join, as well as myself. Share what's going on with you and your dog. You can post pictures, you can post video, you can ask questions, you can answer and help other people. That would be great as well. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. If you look right down there and that subscribe button is red, go ahead and click it, turn it gray. When that happens, a bell will appear right next to it. Click the bell, select all notifications. That way YouTube can notify you every time I post a new video. Also, give this video a big thumbs up. It's the best compliment you can give, and I would really love to get that compliment from you. Thank you so much for being here, and I hope to see you in our next video. Hey, thanks for watching. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you never miss another video.